What's up guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Rob HK and in this video we're gonna talk about the glitch intro in Lumafusion, and we're gonna create an awesome glitch intro by using Lumafusion only. You can also get a peek of the glitch intro here on my screen as well. This is a bit more advanced tutorial as well, but I have included some parts in the video where I slow everything down. I just let it play so you can see exactly what I do, which will be a little bit more beginner friendly. So if you're a beginner, you can still watch this video and create an awesome glitch intro. And if you're a bit more experienced in Lumafusion, you can simply just skip those parts where I say that I will just play this video until we add the next part. And I also need to say that some of these effects added into the video, like the video file itself, some of those effects are taken from the 500 transition pack, which I have on Selfie, and also the 400 starter pack. But enough talk, let's jump into Lumafusion and create this awesome glitch effect. So don't forget to head down to the description below, download the elements before you start making this intro. So let's move over to Lumafusion and make this awesome intro. Roll our intro. So first we're going to start by opening up Lumafusion, and as you can see here is the project that I was working on to make this glitch intro. And before we go over to the tutorial to make this effect, I want to go through this simple project with you guys so you can get a better insight of how I made this intro. And as you can see, there's a lot of glitch lookalike effects, and there's pluses and there's circles that appear inside the intro as well. These are just PNG files, which I made in Photoshop. These are circles and pluses, and I will provide you with the same pluses and circles that I made for this intro. So all you have to do is to go to the description below to download the pluses and the circles. You can also see that I made one text layer and I made some cuts to it as well. And then I simply just change the position and the size of the text to make it look like a glitch effect. But now let's go over and create a new project so we can remake this intro. And we're gonna call this project glitch intro. So we're gonna make this intro in four parts, and we're gonna start with part number one. And part number one is music, and you really want to take your time when you find your music for your intro, because this is the intro that you will put in front of your video for every single upload you do. So what I recommend is to find music which has a consistent beat. What I mean about that is that it has a beat going constantly every fourth second, every third second, every second or something like that, which you can use to cut your clips so your intro will look better. Because what you want to do in an intro is to keep the footage synced with the music, and having a music file which has a consistent beat allows you to easily place those clips at the certain beats of the music. So once we trim down our audio file, we want to go over to Lumafusion's transitions and add a cross dissolve at the end. And the reason why we want to do this right away is so we don't forget it, and we want to finish layer by layer. So once we apply the cross dissolve to the audio file, we're gonna move over to our footage layer. Then we go over to source and into photos, and then we go to videos. And here we're gonna find all the video files that we want to use for the intro. And we're gonna apply every single video clip to the timeline before we go over to the next step. And as you can see on the audio file that we just imported to the timeline, the audio file has certain spikes to it, and we want to match our footage to those spikes. So what you have to do is to play through your music, and then you have to find the beat which comes with each spike of the audio, and you're gonna make a cut to your video file exactly at those spikes. And this will allow you to sync the footage with the music file. We'll be right back. And once we're done applying all the video files, we're gonna go over to source and transition once more, and we're gonna add a cross dissolve at the end of the last footage. The next thing you can do is to go to the beginning of your sequence and you can play through to see if all the clips are synced up with the music. If they're not synced up, you can always readjust the position and the length of each clip. And if that doesn't help, you can always go over to consolidate media and you can consolidate your project. And when you're done applying all your clips to your timeline and everything is synced up, you can go to each clip and you can make a small cuts. But you don't want to make any cuts longer than 7 frames. What I recommend is using 5 frames for every cut. But in some cases where you want to add some text, the frames should be longer. And here we can see that we are doing small cuts to each clip. You can also do multiple cuts to the same clip. It depends on how many glitch effects you want to apply to each clip. So to make these glitch effects, we want to make a cut to our clip. So let's start by making 2 cuts. So we have one part of the clip, which is 5 to 10 frames. And then we're gonna clone this clip and the clip will automatically be placed on top of the cutted part. And then we can adjust the position of this clip on the timeline if we want to do that. But in this case, we're gonna double tap on it so we get into edit. And here we're gonna go to cropping. And then we're gonna adjust the cropping so we get a smaller piece of the footage. We're gonna change the top cropping, the bottom cropping, and the right cropping for this crop. And the next thing we do is to go over to size and positioning. And then we change the position of this layer. And we see that we have a glitch effect applied. And the reason why we can call this a glitch effect is simply because it appears for a short amount of time. If this was about to appear for a longer time, it would just be a simple cut in the clip. So now we're gonna make some more 5 to 10 frame cuts to our footage. And we're gonna do this to every single clip that we want to apply a glitch effect to. You can apply multiple cuts to each clip, or you can apply a simple cut to each clip. It's all about what you want and how many glitch effects you want to apply to each clip. And we're gonna do this same procedure. We're gonna go into cropping on each cutted part that we have cloned. And we're gonna go to size and position, and we're gonna change the position of the footage. So what you're gonna do is to repeat this over and over until you're happy with the glitch effect that you applied to your footage and to your project. And you can also add some different colors to the cutted parts and the clone parts that you are using for the glitch effect to make them pop more. And what I recommend is to add some green color, some blue color, or some red color, because that will really pop that glitch effect. And since this is a tutorial for the more advanced Lumafusion users, I'm gonna let this play out without speeding it up, so it's a bit more beginner friendly, and you will see how I make each glitch effect with the cropping and with the size and positioning and with adding colors. And we will come back when we're gonna apply the pluses and the circles. So now that we're halfway through the intro and we're almost done making the glitch intro, we're gonna go over to our Photos app once more and we're gonna add the pluses and the circles. And what I recommend is to go over to global settings and then change the photo size to around 5 to 10 frames. And as you can see in the Photos app, all the files which has the pluses and the circles is completely white. This is because it's a PNG file and the background is transparent and the pluses and the circles are white. So what you have to do is to tap on each one to see a preview on your previous screen for the element that you want to apply to your timeline. And as I said earlier in this video, I will be providing these elements for free inside the Google Drive folder, so you can easily get access to those in the description below and you can download them and you can simply apply them to your timeline. And I will also provide more of these elements in the future because this is a really unique way to spice up your Lumafusion videos. So once you apply these elements to your timeline, the only thing you have to do is to make them between 1 and 5 frames. And the next thing is to go into edit and then change the position and the size of the elements. And you can also place them so they overlap each other, and you can also place them above two clips so it's used as a form of transition between those two clips, and you can apply as many as you want as long as you have space on your timeline. And I'm also gonna let this one play, so for those of you that are total beginners when it comes to Lumafusion, you can see how I apply these elements of pluses and circles and how I adjust them inside of frame and fit when it comes to position and scale. What I recommend is to render your project before you add the text. As you can see on the timeline, there's a lot of files, just super messy. So what I recommend is to render it first and then go over to Lumafusion again and reapply your rendered file and your rendered intro to Lumafusion, and then you can apply text to your intro. And this allows you to have more space since Lumafusion only allows you to have 3 layers and we basically need to use all of them. So it's really important to render your intro first before you apply the text. We'll be right back. And when we applied all the elements, we are done with our intro. We can go out to our timeline and we can play through and see what we just created. So that's how you make this awesome glitch effect in Lumafusion. And as you saw, there was no other programs or apps we used to make this intro, only the elements that I made in Photoshop. And you can also make elements like this, different elements if you want to use some arrows or whatever you want to make inside another app or another program. Just make sure to render it as a PNG file with a transparent background. So hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you guys make this intro and use it for your videos. And if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe. It really helps me out a lot. We're so close to 10,000 subscribers and we just smashed that 8K mark, and I really appreciate all the support that you give me. So just keep on sharing. The best thing you can do is to share my videos. Let everyone know that we can make insane stuff in Lumafusion with only our phone or our tablet. Don't forget to smash that notification bell to get notified when I upload new videos. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace!